like to see this on your paper. So I'm gonna give you a sheet of paper. It's going to look like this. You're going to measure the weight of the individual pieces in grams, and after you finish constructing your object, you're going to measure the weight of the total. Okay. But I want you to think about how to describe these individual pieces. So how many of you are familiar with Legos? So this is called a brick. And Lego bricks are described by their dimensions area-wise. So this would be a 1 by 1, 2, and these little, those little dimples on top. So that would be a 1 by 1, 2, 12. Okay. This would be a
1 by 4.
This.
2 by 4.
This.
2 by 12.
You would have to 2 by 16. But you get the idea. To describe the brick, you're going to describe the area, the dimensions of the brick.
And make sure you take into consideration like the blue and red one. Both 2 by 4, but one's
right. And so if you have that these pieces are exactly the same dimensions, I would be okay with you putting them together. So these numbers here, what do you think this means?
4 times.
Right. So when you are measuring the mass of your individual pieces, it is totally okay to put all of the pieces that are similar together on your tray. I don't need you to measure because this is 2, 4, 6, 8, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Do you understand what I'm saying? I don't need you to measure 20 objects. Put them all together and measure the weight of the entire set. So this, let's come up with a term for that. What would you want to call that? I've used it as a pulley in my classroom. That's
small.
The wheel. So this.
Okay.
This. These are axles. But this is a peg. Okay. And that is the outer covering of the wheel. This is the hub. But if you're going, you can put these together and make a tire. If you have that on, if you have any questions about how do I describe this object, please let me know. Okay, so I need your materials manager to come and get it. Do you want to return this?
Mr.
In your cooperative groups, just the reporter needs to make your measurements. I learned something new every day. A couple of days ago, this was my something new. These make handy little, you can put your instructions. So they slide out and then fit in to the spot where there's the indentation.
Doesn't matter.
Measure.
Or yes. No, one by.
That one thing you went to for this one, put like two by one instead of two for one.
Yeah, so let's put together the shield that we actually need these that are all tied together and then.
That's just like this.
How many of those pieces are you using?
I think you
can measure the two.
Okay.
Yeah, I got both of these, yeah.
Okay.
That's cool.
She's just doing a piece of help.
Are we measuring?
There's two of them.
No, so we do well.
No, I know, but.
Just to clarify, you need two pieces. Instead of measuring each individual piece, measure the weight of it together.
Red.
Melissa, we need one.
The thing is, that one is like
two. We're just helping, we're just getting all the things.
Square. You're gonna have a four by. Well, we were just putting these flat, like,
oh, yeah, okay, yeah, flat would be more. Well, because then you can search like Google search or search by just a picture.
Oh, yeah.
Well, it would be a bit on technology, but research different ways, using different tools, different types of technology.
So I'm making sure I put one small gear left.
Yes, that's a peg. That's so real.
I was just telling you the number.
Well, let's look at our products here. So like, that's a gear. That's a wheel.
I think there's a handle actually.
Right.
Because they're going to take.
Right.
Two by eight left.
And
here. Did we come up with
it?
No.
Oh. I want to try the search. Actually, we have a lot more than that.
I'm going to connect her. how to identify connectivity. This is an axle.
These tiny little cylindrical things, let's call these axle connectors. These tiny cylindrical pieces, axle connectors.
I had two questions. One is we have three axles that are differentiated. How would you like for us to differentiate?
So in Lego, they're always